Hi gamers, I'm Cyber Settler and today we're playing Space Engineers. So today we are continuing with the Eagle Transporter use cases, and in this opportunity we are going to review the tactical use case, and this is using the Eagle Transporter as a gunship. Well, I call it gunship. Yeah, technically it a gunship is a plane, usually in the military languages used to refer to a plane that targets ground or sea objectives, and it circles around them attacking those targets. In this case, well, since the Eagle Transporter is meant for the moon, I think it makes sense that an Eagle Transporter will attack ground targets. But as you can see in this module that I call it the defense module, I mean, these turrets can attack any kind of target, ground or airborne. Or spaceborne, I should say. And yeah, the thing is that, well, you know that I'm not really much into the weapons in Space Engineers, but I thought that this was a valid use case for the Eagle Transporter, the tactical use case. And also I was trying to see if I could find something about Eagle Transporter as weapons. I know that they have some laser weapon, like without, it's not like a special module, but I couldn't find much else. Also, I think it could be used as some sort of bomber, but right now we are going to test this module. There's a target close by. This is from my last video. It was already there. We attacked it with some drones, and I'm not sure, maybe we damaged some of its propulsion systems, because it seems to be stationary. Also, one thing I want to clarify: the last time I saw some damage in the Eagle Transporter while we were traveling, and it seems that it was due to the thrusters of the command module. So usually these thrusters should be off, right? Because these thrusters. Let me show you these ones here. These are meant to be used when the command module is decoupled from the body, and this happens in an emergency or when you are using the command module as a standalone. Also, I disable the other thrusters here in the sides. Only the ones that pointed to the front are on. Okay, so there you have it. The Eagle Transporter defense module is already working. It's fighting against the meteors. So let's take this one for a test. Let's deactivate. So there is our target right there. By the way, I have the turrets configured so that we can also use them from the cockpit. So the way this module is meant to work best is while the target is under the Eagle Transporter, and that's why I say that this is yes, it's better to use it as a gunship or a bomber, because it's best when you are targeting maybe ground targets. We're getting close. And we have the number two to control the missile launcher. And I think that's it. That's our target right there. But I think we are not still in the within range. Let's try to fire at it. It's too far away. Okay, I don't know exactly where these missiles are impacting. We are so far away. Also, the turrets don't seem to be activated. Yeah, but that's the ship, all right. It's strange, and it's not... Well, the fact that it's not shooting on us, could be due to the distance. But at any moment... As soon as we are closer, we should see that we have some interaction. Okay, 1 kilometers, 140, 137. Okay. Yes, I think we're still too far away. I don't know what's the range of the... And now it seems like it's closer. What's the range of this? I'm not sure. Oh, that seems to have done some damage. What's the distance now? 1 kilometer. What's the range of these weapons though? Is it 500 meters or so? No, it's 900, 800. Uh-huh, there. 700. Okay. Yeah, now here we can see that they're making some impact. Now I think we are crippling it. So this is basically like a rocket launcher, right? It's not missiles. I think they go straight to the target. Yeah, but I think that should do it. Yeah, and I think it's It's already badly hit, right? Okay, so now where is this? No, I lost it. Where was it? This one. There it is. But it doesn't say what distance. Well, I don't have it in the HUD. I think I destroyed some part of it. Some antenna or something. There. Take that. Wow. Okay. That should teach him a lesson. Okay, so that was it. Objective destroyed. Yeah, that was it. Okay, so we could take down this ship. The Eagle transporter had some damage done to it, as you can see in the in the module itself. Yeah, and I think also now up here I was seeing some smoke also from the rear. Ah, here, yes. Well, we took some damage here. But it was not that bad. Let's just repair. We can head to another target. Well, I'm not using any decoy or anything. I think that would make sense in such missions. I wonder where would we put a decoy if we had decoy. I'm not sure. Oh. The damage here was heavy. Well, we had an entire block blown away. No, not one but two. Ah, this is, what is this? Is this the battery? I think these were the batteries. Or the battery was. The battery or the Was this a butter or programmable block? I think was here. And yes, but currently we are not. That was a programmable block. No, this is not the programmable block. Which one is it? Okay, so let's put this back. Okay, now let's target another vessel. There's a commercial ship there. Ooh, but I'm still having repairs. Yes, this area at the bottom tends to take damage because it's the area that is facing the enemy. Okay, I think that's it. Yeah, this area also took some damage. Okay, let's go. That's enough. Oh, and this. Wow, here, I didn't see this. It disappeared. As soon as I think I'm over with the repairs, more things come up. Okay, yes, because this, it makes sense. Now, what was this? Some. And look, and this is the the programmable block we lost. Yeah, that's what happened. Like that, the bottom panel was destroyed, and the programmable block became detached from the rest of the ship. This is what happened. Okay. Wow, lots of repairs. Well, it seems that the Eagle Transporter has a lot of armor, right? It can take damage. It's not like the drone that it's destroyed almost immediately. Okay, I think that's it, hopefully. Okay, now let's go. The next target. What is it again? A commercial freighter. This one is a commercial freighter. Maybe as we come closer, we will see other targets, because I saw several ships. So I don't know, I'm not sure what's the range of the rocket launcher thing. I know that Gatling gun turrets, I think they are 700 meters or so. But I think the rockets are about 1 kilometer, maybe. I didn't check that. And here it's coming. 2 kilometers. Let's reduce the speed. Let's attack in this direction. And it's coming close. Where is it? Oh, we're already receiving some. Okay. I think it's going down. He has still one machine gun, I think. And what is that? Oh. Assailant. Okay. Okay, let's stop there. We need to turn around. Let's view it from outside. I'm already Well, the assailant is dead, I think. There we go. Whoa. The cockpit is damaged. I think that's a decoy or something. What? Because it's just attacking that point. Probably we should control one of the, because it's always attacking one point, and probably he has a decoy. But I think he's out of weapons now, right? Okay. Well, he's taking a beating, but I think our Eagle Transporter is also taking a beating as well. Okay, I think he's already very damaged, probably. Let's stop this. Wow, we took a beating as well. Look at this. From different directions. Look at that. Oh, we lost a turret. We lost a turret here. And the danger here, this is a weak point. The like this is sort of the backbone of the ship. We have this backbone, and it could, if they shoot at it enough, it could break the ship in two. So that's dangerous. They took down one turret. And yeah, this side is very damaged, the right side. Also, we took damage in the, wow, look at this, they blew the door away. We took damage in the command module. But the other ship is completely destroyed. It's a pile of junk, what's left. Pile of parts floating around. Okay, and we also took this assailant as well. Okay, so I think it's not a bad ship to for these attack missions. I think it's a decent ship to perform attacks. So let's head back to the base. Let's see, where are we now? Yes, let's head back to where we were before. And I want to show you guys another module that is also tactical, but it has it's different, it has other features. Okay, so we took down three ships at the end. Not bad. Okay, so we are basically back. Okay, I think this is enough here, and let's just despawn this one. There. Okay, so the other module I wanted to show you guys is, let's bring it up. This, it's called the multi-crew defense module, and as its name implies, this module is for I always place the thing in the wrong okay, let's place it as it should be. I think this, yes. It should be in that way, yes. So this is the multi-crew. And the idea of the multi-crew, let's put a battery because I think it doesn't have battery. The idea of the multi-crew is, as the name implies, to have this thing controlled by several players. So I place like these cockpits all around it so that different players could take posts here in the cockpits, and from there control each of the weapons. So it has four cockpits here, for one for each turret, right? Four cockpits at the sides and one cockpit at the front, and this is meant for the rocket launchers here. So this is meant, and look at that, the drone is smoking. I think either the meteor storm got him or one of these enemy ships while it was patrolling. So yeah, the idea is to have the let's spawn another Eagle transporter so we can see it. I think this is the right way to place it. I'm not sure. Why are we colliding with the ship, right? Okay. Let's spawn it there. Just to see it, how it fits. It's larger than the other one, right? Because of all these cockpit layout thing. But this should be fun, right? To have several multi-crew in this ship and perform some missions. There. So now we can just take out the battery. We don't need it anymore. Okay, so there you have it. And the idea is that you come up here to this, for example, this turret, this cockpit, sorry. And then you can control one of these turrets. So, of course, you will, the Gatling turret. And the other one is called missile turret. But is this really a missile? They behave more like rockets. I think about missiles as something that they target, and they have some autopilot thing where it follows the target somehow. Okay, so if we control one of the turrets, of course these cockpits, they don't have to be really coupled to any particular let's shoot down the our own drone. So this would be an example. Yeah, but I mean, like, if you the convenience in this case is that you have a cockpit where someone is controlling, where someone is posted, and he has this field of view, and as soon as he has eye contact with an enemy, he could then control his turret to shoot at the target. This is the idea. Like, everyone will be responsible for controlling one of the turrets. So that's this one, and I think that's basically it. These are the two kind of modules that I did for tactical use cases. The thing now, I was thinking about having like a bomber as well. That also could be a tactical use case. But I'm not sure how, because with a rocket launcher, it's very effective, right? A bomb is like more difficult to somehow hit a target, right? It's difficult to control, to be able to hit a target. But maybe a bomb could be more destructive. I don't know. Also, you could have one. You could have like some mechanism in the module that will deploy decoys. That would also be really good. I don't know. As I said before, I'm not very familiarized with the weapons. So, where can we see, what kind of weapons do we have? Block weapons. So we have the warhead. A warhead is a powerful explosive that can be used to destroy asteroid, enemy ships, and stations. Safe when unarmed. They can be detonated manually by taking damage or set to detonate after a configuration amount of time. Yeah, so this is the thing. You would use a warhead to... we can have a module that will deploy these warheads. And then we have the rocket launcher. Okay, but I'm not... These are for small weapons. Which one is this? The rocket launcher. This is the rocket launcher. Okay. Guys, forgive me for my ignorance about weapons in Space Engineers, but as I said, I'm not much into that. But here's a rocket launcher, so you could also equip the Eagle Transporter with a rocket launcher. Missile turrets are configurable automatically that target anything hostile within its range. Recurve missiles can be controlled manually from a cockpit. Use conveyors to allow automatic reloading. Okay. And let's see the warhead. Okay, this is the warhead. Yeah, so basically, we should be able to make bombs with this thing, right? Yeah, okay. So, but I'm not prepared for that. This is just like brainstorming. Okay, guys, but I think we will leave it there. So probably, I don't know, maybe in the next episode we will have some bomber module. Well, it's interesting to see, just as an experiment, how you could detonate them. But also, an Eagle Transporter that has warheads is also convenient for mining, for example. This is not only a tactical use case, but also a mining use case where we could just deploy or yeah, drop this warhead in an area where there is ore at some depth, and then we can just skip the drilling part. Okay, so that's everything for this episode. I hope you enjoy it. And also hope to see you in the next one. So this is Cyber Settler signing off.